Welcome back. I'm going to quickly reintroduce to you Jack Logan, founder of Put Down the Guns Now, Young People, and Pastor Lewis C. Duckert, who is from the Shiloh Baptist Church in Wilford, South Carolina. I wanted just everybody to know and thank you both for coming. And we're talking about violence and young people and guns and what we find ourselves in trouble in this country.
Amen, amen, amen. And you know, I'm thinking the pastors all in the communities, the churches, I think we're really concerned because this is a problem. And I really do think if we get in the communities, one-on-one, and just emphasize to our children that God loves them, and no matter what they have done, God can turn your life around. And I think if we have more one-on-one going into communities, mentoring, mm-hmm. I mean, just sacrifice. It's going to take sacrifice because, mm-hmm. I mean, I think about my son, his children, my grandchildren. They all in school. They in athletics, yeah. And they are, you know, in sports. And he got to run. He got to sacrifice when he get off from work. So I think this is what it's going to take for them to have a positive outlook on life. And I think if the pastors, members, just say, I'm going to take one person, mm-hmm. and I'm going to mentor that one mm-hmm. person and okay. sacrifice and spend some time mm-hmm. with that individual, mm-hmm. I think we'll see a difference.
Amen.
Prayer.
So we could start in the churches.
Yes, ma'am. Mm-hmm. Yes, ma'am. And a lot of churches have youth programs.
Oh, I think almost all the churches right. have something for
yes,
young people.
Yes, ma'am. But it's like I said, I'm going to emphasize again, it takes going out in the communities. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it doesn't matter if it's just once a month to show them that we are concerned. We got to get out behind those doors. We know the problem. We just got to get out behind those doors. Okay. And I think this is what's going to help our community.
All right. So are you saying that church people...
Yes, ma'am.
Churchgoers,
yes,
you have to do more than just go to church on
yes,
Sunday.
Ma'am. You know, yes, ma'am. It's more than just sitting in Sunday school, Bible study, and worship service. We got to put some action on these words. I mean, people want to see us in action. Jesus said this. He said, if you love me, you got to do what my commandments. And if you do my commandments, you shall abide in my love. We got to express this love.
That's right.
I mean, you know, it's easy for us to sit behind closed doors and say, God loves you. But we got to demonstrate this love, this kind of love, this agape love that God showed toward mankind by sending his son into this world.
All right. Now, do you think that some of the churches are stepping up to the plate and trying to do something about this? And what can just all of us out there, people watching this show today?
Yes, ma'am. I believe some churches are doing it. I believe we are doing it. You know, a lot of traditional church get... We are talked about, I'm pastoring a traditional church, but my goal is to reach out and tell people about God's love. And we are a small congregation, but we love people, and we express God's love by the things that we have in our churches to reach this community. And we're living in some evil times, and we can all witness to that, but what are we doing about it? Are we really going out trying to win souls? I mean, Mr. Logan brought this out earlier. Are we really going out to win souls for Jesus Christ?
Law enforcement can't do it all.
No, they can't do it all. No, ma'am. You're absolutely right. It's up to, they say, God will bless us. Mm-hmm. You know, he'll bless us. If we do his will and we be serious about doing his will, he'll bless us.
You know, I was telling Pat, y'all off air. I remember when I didn't know God, and former State Senator David Thomas.
Yes.
He was a Republican. He and his wife would say, Jack, you want to go eat with us?
Right.
Or take
right.
me to their home. Spend one-on-one time.
Right, right.
If every person throughout the state, it started in South Carolina, who leave church, headed to Ruby Tuesday, to whatever restaurant they're going to, would just stop along the way and pick up one person and take them with them.
Man.
You'd be surprised, because when it was done to me, I knew I had somebody who loved me. When they would take me to their own home and eat and take me out to eat, no matter what I was wearing. And I think when these pastors
Amen.
And these church, not just the pastors, all these people come out of church every Sunday, you would have thousands of people going out to eat with somebody in that restaurant
right,
to
right.
sit there with them and show them, give them the love. You might share it with you when I went to Calvary in Simpsonville one Sunday with David Thomas. And before I got to know God, the pastor down there was preaching from the book of Romans. Mm-hmm. I didn't have a Bible, but the church Bible. And I picked it up and I kept flipping the pages trying to find the book of God. And the Bob Jones students presented me a Bible. I never will forget that.
Okay.
But that's what needs to be done. You know, people need to take, and I totally agree with him. That's what, it don't. If let's forget about Sunday. It can be during the week.
Amen.
I see so many women, even with myself, when I'm not dressed or something like that, don't know me. And you mentioned earlier, people, women be scared. But I see women on their way to church and men, black and white, with the church clothes on. I be in a store, not to me, but to other young people. They'll walk by them and won't even say good morning or good afternoon. One Sunday, I had a kid who was doing his community service. He was graduating from our program. I took him to eat at SNS out of appreciation for what he had done. Some church people recognized me. They came over and spoke to me. There sat that 15-year-old boy. They did not even acknowledge him because he was not even where. He had his baseball cap on a T-shirt. That's how I picked him up, and that's how I, because it don't matter what he's wearing.
Right.
They could have at least acknowledge that kid.
Amen.
And we need people to give that kind of love.
That's true. That's true. You're true. Because, you know, you think about these gangs, they show a lot of these guys attention. And a lot of times, this is
You just said
attention.
It. Mm-hmm. Yeah. They join these gangs because they belong.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
They have a sense of belonging.
Mm-hmm. Yep. That's true.
That's one of the key reasons.
That's true.
And then they get caught up in a lot of evil activities.
Yes,
but
ma'am.
The attraction to some of these people is they have no family. Mm-hmm. Many of them have no family life or no security. So this gives them a sense of
security.
You belong to somebody.
Yeah. And you get to know them. They're very intelligent people.
Yes,
Very matter of fact, earlier today, on my way to work, one inboxed me and said, Mr. Jack, what you doing today? I said, I'm headed to work. He said, oh, I said, well, don't get in no trouble. You know, they just want people to talk to or spend time with. You got not just male. You got a lot of females out here now too. You have a lot of female, but it's going to take
women
to help these women, girls.
All right, we all know we have a problem. Now, how do we go about fixing it? We can't we cannot expect law enforcement.
That's true.
To do it.
That's true. I think teaching is one of the instruments that we can use in the churches. You know, we all. God have blessed us so we got automobiles, nice homes, and I think Mr. Logan brought it out. It's no harm just to sacrifice and show somebody some love by taking them to lunch. You know, we got restaurants around. I think about my granddaughters. They love QT, you know. And sometimes we see guys standing outside of QT. I mean, it may not be but 5 minutes. But 5 minutes can make a difference in a person's life. Mm-hmm. You tell them, walk up to them and say, God loves you. Mm-hmm. And he can help you to live a better life. Mm-hmm. You know, do you want to turn your life over to the Lord? I mean, it's an easy approach, but we got to just implement this into the members and some of the preachers. You know, I mean, we live in that kind of time now. You know, some look at it as a profession. You know, you go to church, preach 25, 30 minutes, go home, kick your heels up and watch television. But it's more than that. Mm-hmm. And I think we all know that. It's more than that. I mean, we got hospital visitation, nursing homes. I mean, I do all this. And my wife says sometimes, she said, I don't see how you, but God give us the strength.
Mm-hmm. Right.
And once we start, we got to break the ice. We got to get outside the box.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we got to show people some love. And
so this is something that each and every one of us
can
do.
Each and every one can do.
In a simple way.
Right.
It doesn't cost you money. Mm-hmm. But you know, I think a lot of people would do what you're saying, would go up to some, maybe a stranger, and invite them out for a meal.
Right.
But they're afraid.
That's true. That's true.
They're afraid because there is a lot of violence and a lot of things going on, and they're afraid to get.
That's true. That's true. We have to realize that. But, you know, the Bible says the fear of man is a snare. Mm-hmm. Fear not man, that it can only destroy the body. But fear man, fear one that who can destroy both body and soul. So it's best to fear God over man. And when we fear God, he'll take the fear out of us with man.
Do you think, and this is kind of a bad question to ask you, but do you think that Christians we've fallen down on the job?
Yes, ma'am.
Have we failed to do what Christ wants us to do? We go to church, we spend, give a, you know, a donation, we try to do the right thing, but somehow maybe we're not doing the right thing.
That's true. And I think this is what we got to start putting emphasis on. Me, myself, I'm guilty of this a lot of times. We have the opportunity to witness about the Lord. We don't take advantage of it. But I think by this talking, we are talking among ourselves, you know, iron sharpeneth iron. That's what the Bible say. Mm-hmm. And by us coming together and touching and agreeing on what we need to do for our communities, our young people, I think this is going to be helpful. I think this radio station that's airing this program is going to be a help. We just need a little something to open our eyes up. Mm-hmm. And God uses people, individuals, to help us see one another where we are with the Lord. It's a challenging to be a Christian, especially these days and times. But I believe with God's strength and help, He will give us the boldness that we need to go out in these communities.
And especially to reach our young people.
Yes, ma'am.
Because many of them don't have the solid foundation of a family. That's what it all goes back to.
That's true. That's what it goes back to. You know, they just wandering in the wilderness. And, you know, I'm like Mr. Lowe, I came up through Sunday school. I mean, that was my basic.
Yeah.
And I didn't want to go a lot of times, but my mom made me go. A lot of time I would take the money and spend it, go to the store and spend it on cookies. But it had an impact in my life. Right. When I came to the crossroads of my life and I realized that I needed Christ, my mind went back when I went to Sunday school as a little boy. And I was watching Billy Graham one night. He started talking about the seed by the wayside when trials and tribulations and temptation. And I think that's why I have such a heart for young people. Because, I mean, I was just 27 years old when I got saved. And I can tell young people, you know, no matter what you've gone through, God can turn it around. Mm-hmm. I don't care what you've done in your life. God can erase it.
Right.
And give you a new start.
Amen.
New creature in Christ Jesus.
He will.
And God will do it.
And we need is whatever church we go to, take those thoughts of yours and put them into action.
Yes, ma'am. Yeah.
Bless you. Thank you for coming.
And
bless you.
We need to pray and we need to put our young people first and reach out, all of us, wherever you are. God bless you. Stay happy. We'll see you next time.